I'm McKenna. I'm on the field hockey team. I'm the class treasurer. I play softball. I'm in Key Club. And I, along with Kyle, am going to be one of the MCs for our school assemblies and step-up days. We're so excited to have a new class come to HHS.
Hi, I'm Kyle, and I play soccer here at Hermon High School. I'm a member of Student Council, Student Advisory, and also a member of Honors Diploma. I'm the other MC this year, and I'm so excited to welcome you all here for Step Up Day.
We are the MCs for Step Up Day, and we'll guide you through this morning's events, along with giving you some advice that is very helpful when going from middle to high school. We're so excited to show you how awesome Hermon High School is.
I'd like to introduce the administration at Hermon High School, Mr. Walsh, Mrs. Smith, and Mrs. Bieberstein. Here at Hermon High School, students see Mr. Walsh and Mrs. Bieberstein and Mrs. Smith in the halls and in the class all the time. We form great relationships with all of them.
You do need one fine art credit. The next five presentations are great examples of how you could get that credit. Personally, for my freshman year, I took band, and now as a sophomore, I'm taking pants and plan on taking pants for the next 3 years. This shows that just because you get your one fine art credit your first year of high school, you can always do more art credits throughout your 4 years.
Adding on to what McKenna has said, I would like to introduce our chamber choir. There is no stigma around joining any club or activity at Hermon High School. No one gets made fun of or feels excluded. It's a great way to meet new friends. We often see students who are involved in both art and athletics. Now let's listen to how great our chamber choir is.
I honestly have never heard anyone say anything bad about this class. Some people take it year after year. When this class started, we had 3 classes, but it's become so popular that we have doubled the amount of classes offered. If you're not already sold yet, all you have to do is listen to their performance.
The theater program at Hermon High School. It's a great program that many people enjoy. Here at HHS, there are many options, including the fall musical, one act, spring play, ITS, theater arts, stagecraft. So many people in the school are involved, and our instructor works hard to make sure students are able to make it to sports practices and rehearsals. so don't think you have to choose between one of them. This improv performance is by theater arts students.
After careful consideration, I have decided to overlook my nephew's conduct to you.
Thank you, Lady Bracknell. But my own decision, however, is unalterable. I decline to give my consent.
Come, dear. How old are you?
I'm past. There's a third voice, a voice in disguise. You'll be hearing a trio and not a duo. Duet. With both of your eyes. Kindly. With both of your. We. Pro. Do you and remarkable blend. Will we raise our three voices on high? We're in perfect accord from beginning to.
The king and the minstrel and
yet if one of our trio should ever depart, then the others would languish and die.
Wow, how great was that skit? The best part of that is that it was all done in class and they're receiving an art credit for this class. Another way to receive an art credit is by taking an art class. Take a look at this video created by students taking different leveled art classes. The movie was influenced by the show The Office.
Hey Tanner, your color schemes look good. Have you thought about what you're going to take next year for art?
I'm not really sure yet.
So you've come to the master for guidance. Is that what you're saying, Grasshopper?
Actually, no, you called me over here. I've been in Mr. Pryor's Art Foundations class for about a semester now.
Why'd you take the class?
I just needed the credit.
I've always liked to draw and paint.
I want to take photography and graphic design.
I just want to do my work.
Seriously?
So far, we've done a lot of drawing and painting.
What are you looking forward to this year?
I don't know, something messy.
I hear we get to make some sculptures out of clay and other things.
I really hope we get to do photography at some point.
Art Foundations is a course for all skill and interest levels. We dabble in a little bit of everything. Students need to complete Art Foundations if they plan to take any other art elective course.
Did you guys hear that Art Foundations is only half a year next year? Yeah,
so really? Is it a full credit?
No, it's just half like credit. So people can take it the first semester and then take another art class the second.
I wish I could have done that.
That's true. Art Foundations is only a semester course from now on. I decided to change it so students could start taking other arts elective courses sooner. Especially if you know what you want to take or what you want to focus on. You're welcome.
So incoming freshmen get to take another art elective? That's not fair.
Only after they pass Art Foundations, and then they can choose drawing or crafts.
What's crafts?
Crafts is a new course. We're going to create things that still require students to practice the creative process, but not focus so much on the fine art of drawing and painting.
Mr. Pyro, what kind of projects will you be doing in crafts?
We're going to make things like mosaics, do some bookmaking, maybe make some jewelry, do some origami.
Oh, why'd you wait for us to graduate? I'm gonna have to sneak in next year.
I like to mix my own colors. The trick is to start with the lightest color. They'll all get to know each other at the party, but the lightest color is the hardest. I'm serious about this stuff. I'm precise about the amount I combine, and I only mix with a palette knife. It's a trick passed down for generations in my family. It's probably the best thing I do.
Other than crafts, freshmen who complete Art Foundations can also take drawing and design. This class is heavily focused on drawing from observation and creating two-dimensional art using a variety of materials like graphite, charcoal, pastels, color pencils, illustration markers, and so on.
Yeah.
That was impressive.
Do you know that you do not need a language course to graduate from Hermon High School?
But it is highly recommended for students wanting to show their rigor on their transcript. Typically, colleges look for 2 years for a world language. If you're not sure if you should take a world language or not, speak to Ms. Berry. I know I told you that you don't need a world language to graduate, but one thing changed is personal finance is a requirement to graduate. This class is taught by Ms. Debe, who everyone loves. She makes great brownies, by the way. And she also teaches computer concepts and desktop publishing, as well as accounting, which is my personal favorite. All are elective classes designed to help you transition to the real world of technology after high school. So keep those classes in mind. I also want to mention a couple of great new classes that we have now. Journalism, which counts as an English credit for seniors, Computer Science Principles, which also has an AP option, and Steam Powered Science, which teaches you how to use a 3D printer.
Now, if you're wondering how successful our athletic programs are at Hermon High School, next time you're here, look for the many state championship trophies and banners in the hallway.
I just joined book club because it gave me something to do during the pandemic, and I like good books, so double win for me, I guess.
Hi, welcome to book club. We meet Thursdays, 2:15 to 3, but today we're staying to 3:15. And I love being the advisor for book club. I get to read things I never thought I'd read before. And here are our wonderful book club members. They'd like to tell you a little bit why they like book club.
I like book club because I get to talk to people about my thoughts on books, and like she said, we get to read a bunch of books I never thought I'd read. Like this is, what did you call it?
Narrative nonfiction.
Nonfiction, and I never thought it would be something I like, and it's really interesting.
Awesome.
I
kind of
like it
because,
you know, typically I never think I'd read this type of book, and I end up reading it, and it's okay if, say, you're falling a little behind. It's okay if you have opinions, and it's just okay here. We're all like one big family having fun reading books.
Do you have anything to share? Awesome. Well, we hope you join us next year. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Trinity from the Civil Rights Team. Our mission as a civil rights team is to try and create a better environment for our students, regardless of race, skin color, ethnicity, ancestry, national origin, religion, disabilities, gender, including expression and identity, and sexual orientation. We believe that bias-based behaviors on those things are especially damaging, and because of their unique behaviors, warrant specific preventative efforts. We encourage our school community to engage in this important work so that students of all identities can feel safe, welcome, and respected for who they are. We often offer a lot of opportunities for community service hours during a normal year, such as doing concessions for the unified basketball games or just taking photos for the day of welcome. There is a lot of different leadership opportunities as well. We don't have elected positions, but we do have a leadership committee that is typically in charge of a lot of things that we do as the civil rights team. Again, during a normal year, which this is not a normal year, we would have meetings once every week for 30 minutes, one day of the week. And we also have responsibilities as a civil rights team to go to trainings and conferences to better ourselves as humans and learn techniques from other schools. Here are just a couple photos from past projects that have happened, and t-shirts, and all kinds of things that you may be interested in. And these are just things that we do as a civil rights team, and I hope you enjoy. But she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Hi, my name is Veronica Chiquetto, and I'm a historian for the class of 2023. Basically, the job of the historian is to take pictures of important events such as Winter Carnival and Spirit Week, and then write a little summary about what happened, how people placed, what the theme was for each day. And you keep those on a Google Drive form or wherever you want to keep them. And after 4 years of high school, all the historians get together and they create a slideshow for senior moments, and you get to review it when you graduate.
Hi, I'm McKenna Nevels, and I'm the treasurer for the class of 2023. My role as being the treasurer is to make sure that my class is meeting their goal each year to be able to pay for important senior activities like senior banquet, prom, and even graduation. My fellow class officers and advisors all work together to think of fundraisers that our class could do throughout the year to make sure that we are all staying on track of things. Not only do I mostly handle the money, but I also make sure that my class is motivated to participate in these fundraisers. This role, or any role in being a class officer, helps keep you very motivated and well aware of what is going on in our school and our class, and it's a great way of staying active with your school. We're very excited for new activities to come up and new students to join HHS.
My name is Eva Benjamin, and I am the Vice President of the class of 2024. As a class officer, I participate in managing and discovering ideas for fundraisers. These fundraisers help raise money for activities such as prom, graduation, homecoming, and more. As Vice President, I fulfill the responsibilities of the President when they're absent, attend meetings, and write and present speeches. Being a class officer will help you develop valuable skills, including leadership, communication, and cooperation.
Bonjour. Aujourd'hui, je vais vous montrer comment faire des brownies. Pour les faire, vous devez aller à l'épicerie pour les ingrédients. De l'épicerie, vous pouvez trouver et de la levure chimique, du coca en poudre, de l'extrait de vanille, du sel, versez le mélange dans une petite casserole. Mettre la casserole dedans pour 15 à 25 minutes. De délicieux brownies. Vous pouvez les donner à vos amis ou à votre famille. Ils sont parfaits pour les fêtes et pour le dessert.
Hey, the club we're here to talk about today is Hawks for Change. We're a student-led group who focuses on bettering yourself, your family, your school, and your community. This is what the 4 and H4C stands for.
We meet once a week after school in the Writing Center, and in this program you can earn many community service hours through the different projects that we do.
Some examples of projects that we do include the Yellow Tulip Project, food pantry, hygiene baskets in the bathrooms, and sending cards to local resident homes.
In past years, our club would travel to conferences and meet with other groups like us. This offers good leadership opportunities for our members.
In this club, we get the opportunity to work in groups and work on teamwork skills, work on problem solving, and gain responsibility and work ethic. That's the gist of it!
Key Club is a student-led organization that provides multiple community service opportunities. Key Club's mission is to encourage leadership through serving others. Our most popular service activities and fundraisers are Trick or Treat for UNICEF, The Thirst Project, Alex's Lemonade Stand, and Camp Capella's Polar Dip.
I'm the vice president.
Hi, I'm Jamie. I'm the bulletin editor.
I'm Kelsey.
And I am the president.
Hi, my name's Amanda. I'm the treasurer of Key Club.
I'm Emily, and I'm the secretary of Key Club.
I like everything about Key Club.
It gives me opportunities for community service.
I enjoy how we get plenty of opportunities to help out the community around our local town.
My favorite thing is that we get to go out in the community and help others.
Hello, my name is Mrs. Haskell, and I'd like to talk about Mu Alpha Theta, Hermon High School's Math Honor Society. Mu Alpha Theta is a national math honor society dedicated to inspiring keen interest in mathematics, developing strong scholarship in the subject, and promoting the enjoyment of mathematics in high school. This honor society is open to all students in grades 9 through 12. Entry requirements include having a 3.0 average in all math subjects, which would be on a 100-point scale and 85 and above. You need to be enrolled in a math class above Algebra 2, and you need to show interest in and actively participate in the math community. This requirement is fulfilled by attending 5 math team meets. Senior members will receive honor cords to wear at graduation. Mu Alpha Theta, a way to recognize you for your outstanding math achievements. Join today. Hi, my name is Mrs. Haskell, and I'm here today to talk to you about the Hermon High School math team. Math, the only subject that counts. If you love problem solving, you're looking for a challenge, join the math team. A fun way to interact with other students who love math and love solving problems. 6 meets per year, optional practices, the math team works with whatever schedule you have. It's a fun place to work on challenging problems. Hundreds of students attend math meets every year. Here at Hermon, mathletes are wanted. Release your inner geek and make Hermon proud. All are welcome, and it's not for grades, it's for glory.
And I'm president of National Honor Society.
Hi, I'm Kelsey, and I'm the treasurer of National Honor Society.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Bjorklund, and I'm the advisor of NHS.
Hey, Kenzie, so I was wondering, what is NHS about?
NHS is a group of juniors and seniors in high school who show exceptionally well, good grades, and also have great community service and leadership skills.
Oh, so if I'm interested in applying to NHS, like what should I do? Should I join clubs, like do sports teams?
Yeah, that would be a great idea. If you started looking into different leadership opportunities, like a team captain or just like even a student council representative, then we look at that and see how you do in your leadership and also do some community service. And that could be anything to help the community out.
Mm-hmm. And is this like a club that I should be looking into joining?
You should look into it because it does look really good on college applications, and it also is a really good opportunity to help out your community and your peers and other people who live in the town.
Oh, okay, cool, thanks.
Hola, me llamo Kyle. He estado un estudiante en la clase de español en Hermon High School durante 2 años. Spanish is a great language to learn, especially at Hermon High School. This class is very interactive, so you're always doing new activities to help you better understand the language. Spanish is the second most spoken language in the world, so learning it here at Hermon High School can greatly help you when you want to travel, meet new people, and even help you in your future job.
For most of us, high school is when we discover who we want to be as people without all of the harsh judgment from the people in the world around us. But for some students, expressing themselves comes with a different set of issues and sometimes judgment from their peers. The mission of the HHS Gay Straight Alliance is to create a safe and inclusive place for all students, regardless of sexual orientation or gender identity, and to educate those unfamiliar with LGBTQIA+ matters so that our school can be a more positive, accepting environment for everyone.
We welcome members of the community, those who wish to know more about the community, and allies who work to advocate and support members of the community. We accept and love everyone for who they are and inspire to make a positive change in our school, even if that just means giving a safe space to one of our members.
GSA meets Tuesdays after school until 3 o'clock with Ms. Cook. Meetings can be joined in person or virtually using the Google Meets link located at the top of the GSA Google Classroom. Post-COVID, we hope to have meetings from 2:15 to 3:30 so that we don't have to end so early. Thanks, COVID. During our meetings, we have various student-led lessons about issues and topics surrounding the LGBTQ+ community. We have almost always walked to Duncan afterwards.
During meetings, we do a variety of different LGBTQ+ centered activities, such as having student-led lessons on LGBTQ+ history, Kahoots, and other LGBTQ+ trivia, having over guest speakers, and hanging up ally posters around the school to make it a more welcoming environment for LGBTQ+ and students. And above all, just being a safe place for our community and allies to talk about these kinds of things without fear of being hurt or harassed.
GSA also encourages creativity even outside of the classroom, which has resulted in creating many LGBTQ+ pieces, including, but not limited to, Ren's arm candy, stars and jars made to look like pride flags, and a few of the numerous pride flags if they were character designs.
GSA is inclusive, open to anyone, and we all have lots of fun. We learn a lot about the LGBTQIA+ community together, from our history to each other's personal experiences with discovering the gender and sexuality. Whether you're an ally of the community, a full-fledged member of it, or just someone who has an open mind and is ready to hear others out, then maybe consider Hermon High School's Gay-Straight Alliance.
Hello, my name is Mrs. Haskell, and today I'll be talking about the academic support options that are offered by Hermon High School. We are here to help you prepare for your transition to career, college, and community. Here at Hermon High School, we have a lot of academic support options. We have some math and science intervention for help with all math and science subjects. There's a writing center for online feedback for any written material. We have intervention periods, designated times to meet with any teacher. There are also peer tutors from the National Honor Society so that students can learn from other successful students. Math and Science Intervention. From 7:30 a.m. to 3 p.m. every school day, there's a full-time certified teacher available during all study halls. This would be to provide homework help, review class material, enhance study skills or organization, finish or make up tests, and make up any absent work. We have a writing center. This is an area for peer-reviewed feedback for any written material. Students can submit online 24/7 through their school emails, and then they will receive feedback on any written material. This is peer reviewed with teacher supervision. If you've got writer's block, they can help you get started. We have intervention periods. These are scheduled times to meet with any teacher. The entire school goes into the same study hall, and it's a school-wide study hall with all teachers available. So homework help, makeup tests, extra instruction. These have very low teacher-to-student ratios, so it's a great time to get extra help. We also have peer tutoring with the National Honor Society members. This is personal, individualized help with a successful student. So it's one-on-one peer tutoring with someone who already has gone through the course and knows what they're talking about. This is very helpful for organization as well as mentoring. Each year, Hermon High School students attend thousands of help sessions. We are here for you, and we look forward to your success. Go Hawks!
My favorite thing about Spirit Week is that everybody gets to join in and you get to see everybody dress up.
And we're running one hell of a something. They're gonna see us from outer space, light it up. Like we're the stars of the human race. When the lights turn it down, they don't know what they heard. Strike the march, play it loud, giving love to the world. We'll be racing on.
My
My favorite part of Spirit Week is being able to have fun with all of my students and promote school spirit in a non-academic setting. Try so hard, and then I get at school and everyone has like way more creative, better costumes than I have, but I think that's awesome because it shows how spirited our students are. Spirit Week is the different memories. And I love hanging out with my class. That was really bad.
Put it out, out, out. We can light it up, 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 so they can't put it out, out, out. We can light it up, 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 so they can't put it out, out, out. We can light it up, 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 so they can't put it out, out, out. When the lights turn it down, they don't know what they heard. Strike the march, pray it loud, giving love. We gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We gonna let it burn, 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 burn. Gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We gonna let it burn, 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 burn. When your eyes turn down, they don't know what they heard. Shut the match, burn it down, giving love to the world. Don't be raising your hands, shining up to the sky. 'Cause we got the fire, fire, fire.
Thank you so much for joining us. Ms. Berry is going to be doing course advising over the next 2 weeks.
Now, Ms. Berry, your counselor for your first year at Hermon High, will speak.